Welcome to the link this evening, and tonight we're discussing land, but specifically leases. And we're going to discuss on the do's and don'ts and things you should watch out for when you go for land to do business in terms of leasing. Welcome back, and my guest tonight is Jet Mwebaze. Some people call you counsel.
Yes.
Jet Mwebaze is a lawyer with Kampala Associated Advocates. Partner.
Correct.
I don't want to miss that one. We're talking about land and leases. Let's break down this animal called leases. What are the several ways leases can be acquired?
First of all, there are four land tenure systems in Uganda, the way you can hold land. You can hold it as mairo, freehold, leasehold, or customary, or what they call communal.
Okay.
So those are the different four. So we'll concentrate on the lease, as you said. Now, in leases, you can have either a lease. You as a lessee, you can get a lease from a controlling authority, if it is public land, or from an individual. If I have my land, I can give you a lease. If I have a mairo, I can give you a lease.
Okay.
If I have a freehold, I can still give you a lease. If I have a lease, I can still give you a sublease. If it is allowed by the law.
So if I have a lease,
yes.
I can lease to you by extension.
Yes, I can, what we call a sublease.
Okay.
If I have a lease from a controlling authority of 49 years, I could lease it to you for 25 years if I am allowed by my lease agreement to sublease.
Okay.
So those are the four different types. Now, for leases that you want us to concentrate on, of course, the time allows, it's a bit wide, but we will just break a few pointers for what people need to look out for. If you are getting the lease from a controlling authority, in this case, in Uganda, for the case of Uganda, the Uganda Land Commission, or district land boards, then there are processes you go through and then get a title.
Okay.
If you are getting it from an individual, then the individual already has a title, either a freehold or a mile interest, and then he's only going to give you a lease.
Okay.
So, but what governs the relationship in both cases, whether the land is public land or private land, individual land, is the terms of your lease, that lease agreement. It is the one which shows you the do's and the don'ts. It has all the terms of your lease.
Okay.
How long is your lease? What are you supposed to do? What are you not supposed to do on that land? When does the lease terminate or expire? The duration of the lease should be in there. What are the renewal processes? Is it automatically renewed? And most of the leases actually are not. There must be a provision on what terms can it be renewed. And immediately, because the relationship is governed by the lease agreement, the day the lease agreement expires, you have no land. You must either reapply, if it is a controlling authority, with other applicants and line up.
You are competing
with everybody else. If it's your land and it has the lease has expired and I get to know, I go to the district and reapply for the same land.
Okay.
So you line up with me even when you are the one.
Can I reapply in advance?
Yes. In fact, you are advised to do so because that's if you have 1 or 2 years running, you should reapply.
Okay.
And confirm that you complied with the terms of the lease.
Okay.
So that's a bit of that lease. But what people need to watch out for are those, what are the premiums payable? Because you have to pay premiums. Is ground rent applicable if you are in Kampala? Who is going to pay it? You find people, when you breach the lease agreement, the entity or the individual who gave you a lease is called a lessor.
Yes.
And you who got the lease, you are called a lessee with a double E at the end. If you violate the lease terms, the entity or the individual has the right of what we call re-entry So somebody will re-enter without recourse to court. Mm. You violate the terms of the lease, they re-enter.
It's like a breach of contract.
Absolutely. Yeah. Once this, under breach of contract, once you breach the contract, you don't walk in here. If I supply you TVs here and you don't pay and breach, I don't walk in here and pick them. Mm. I must sue you and get an order. Mm. But this, in the cases of leases, the right to re-enter is just...
I can take over.
Quickly, you come and re-enter.
Let's move on to Jed. Due diligence or homework must be done as I anticipate to lease a piece of land. What is that? What's the homework I must do?
In fact, this is the bedrock of all problems. If you go to the land division, half of the problems rotate around failure to carry out due diligence.
Mm, homework.
Homework. Mm. People who want to lease the land are in such a hurry. When you ask them, they say, no, we must conclude the transaction today. I am going to lose this land. I need to lease it here and now. Then you tell them, no, you cannot lose this land. Mm. It's not your land.
Yeah.
You can only lose the money because that's what is yours. Mm. So you must carry out due diligence. In due diligence, first of all, if it is a controlling authority, is this the authority that has mandate to, in fact, lease out that land?
Mm.
Does this land fall under Uganda Land Commission or it falls under the district land boards?
Mm.
If it is individual land, first of all, carry out a search on the title.
Mm.
Confirm that Setumba, who says I am Setumba in this title, is the Setumba before you.
Mm.
Is this title genuine? Mm. We have seen titles in the name of Setumba, but there are three different land titles.
Absolutely.
One is for a swamp. Another one is for some anthill. Another one is the real title. So you must carry out due diligence. Let people not be in a hurry, and you need the business community. Don't be in a hurry to lose your money in these matters of land. So the due diligence is very critical on who has the authority to give you this land. So you'll find that land does not, some of the land you find that it falls under a forest reserve.
And you don't know.
And you don't know. And for you, go and apply, and then they generate for you a minute, and then they give you a title. This is not the authority.
This is where we see the Bamagamere.
Yes, the land is in a forest reserve, but they gave a title.
Mm.
The land falls in a game reserve, but the district gave you a title. So you must carry out that due diligence before you, because once you get a title, a lease, you are going to invest your money there.
Mm.
So you are not only going to lose the land, you're also going to lose your investment.
Let's move on, Jed. What are my rights as the person who gets the lease vis-a-vis the person who gives me the lease, the owner of the land? What are my rights, me who is getting the lease?
First of all, those rights are not automatic.
Yeah.
Each lease, whether it is given by the controlling authorities or by individuals, has different terms. Now, you could have a lease. If I am going to plant trees and I need a lease of 25 years, it's different from another person who wants to do a mine, and mining is going to take another 55 years.
True.
So the terms, whatever your rights, and rights are also supposed to be embedded in that lease. And you need to find somebody competent and qualified to negotiate for you that lease and put the terms in that lease that will protect you. What you are calling your rights.
My rights.
So the obligations or the terms therein, the exit clauses, the clauses that will protect you, the renewal, so that you make sure that you have some renewal. Remember, under the law, whatever is fixed on the land belongs to the land.
Yes.
If you get a lease from me for 10 years, if I have a freehold, and then you plant your trees that mature in 15 years, after 10 years, the trees belong to me.
Imagine.
I will re-enter because I have not renewed it, end of story. So you must make sure what kind of business do you want to carry out on the land, so that then you negotiate your lease terms so they can fit within what you want to do.
Okay.
If you want to build rentals or a school, if you want to go and carry out farming, and you want only to do maize, you can do this for 5 years, because there are two seasons in a year.
And you,
so if you come to, if you come to me and tell me to negotiate for you a good lease, I will say, what do you want to do if it's maize? 10 years is good. And remember, you are supposed to pay premiums every year, depending on what you agree. You can either pay every year, you can pay every after 3, 4, 5 years, depending on whatever terms you agree on. So the rights and obligations are enshrined in that agreement called a lease agreement that is embedded in any title.
Okay.
So whenever it's private land if it is a freehold, and if it is a mile title, you must extract a title. You use that agreement, pay stamp duty, 1%, now I think it's 1.5, pay all the other transactional dues, and then go to the registry, file 3 copies. You can keep one so that if the others are in the system, you have a received copy. And finally, they will generate a deed,
a deed,
and then a title.
Okay.
It simply means that if I had 10 acres and I have leased to you, if I had 10 acres of freehold interest and I have leased to you 5, but I want to sell my entire 10 acres to another third party, that other third party must buy my 10 acres subject to your interest. Until your lease has expired, you are covered.
I cannot be touched.
You cannot be touched.
Are there lease time frames? I hear 49.99. Are they the only ones?
No, 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 Sam. The 49 and 99 is the practice of that they use for public lands. In fact, what people don't know is that initially, the initial period for those is 5 years.
Okay.
They first give you 5 years and they give you conditions. If you want it for farming, you must have put in place a dam, like a small house or something. If it is for construction, development here, residential, you must have put some materials, fenced it off. You must show. They can't give it to you for 5 years. The extension to 49 is after they have satisfied that the terms in the lease now, in the lease, you have you have followed what the lease was saying. So they can be, and in fact, what people need to know is that you can, for those leases, for the leases given by the controlling authorities, the law now in place allows you to convert that leasehold, that lease from a lease to freehold. So that you now have it, you know, the difference between leases and the other two, Milo and freehold, is that the other ones are held in perpetuity.
Yes.
There is no expiry date.
But the lease has expired.
The lease has an expiry date. And I can tell you for certain that 49 years look like many years. I've seen a title which has 3 years to go and it was 99 years.
Wow.
So don't leave mess to the guys behind. You can convert them now. Then it wasn't possible.
Yeah.
Now you can apply to convert your leasehold if it is by the controlling authority. But if it is by individuals, then you can't convert
you
it.
Buy.
You have to buy.
One more important issue, Jane, before we go. Communal land, people go to the to invest on communal land. How does that work with leasing?
First of all, communal land or customary land, most of it is not titled. That's why it is called that, it is communal land, is not titled.
Yeah.
But there is a law which allows you to convert. You can convert the conversion from customary or communal land to leasehold.
Okay.
So you still apply to the, most of that land, you apply to the district land boards, wherever it is located, most of the areas. So you apply and then it is brought under the RTA or the Registration of Titles Act.
Okay.
Then you are able to get that leasehold and then be able to sublease to the investor. Or once it has become a lease, you quickly turn it into a freehold and then lease to the investor. Because even under our laws, foreigners or foreign companies are not allowed to hold the first two. No, to hold the first two. They are allowed to buy.
Perpetuity.
They are not allowed to hold Milo and freehold. You can only hold leaseholds. So if you convert your customary into leasehold, then you are able to, I mean, into freehold, then you are able to immediately to, convert it into leasehold, I mean freehold, and then be able to lease it out to the investor.
Okay.
Then the investor will be safe with his 25 or 49 or 99. Some of them have, they add a clause there in and say, I've given you a lease for 99 years, but there will be no right of re-entry. and that as to whether that is legal or not is a different...
That's part of the issues we are discussing.
Yes.
You know, James, I told you 15 minutes just run away before we do anything.
I told you it's a bit wide.
Yes.
You need a bit of time to digest it. But those are the main issues that people need to look out, especially the due diligence, the terms. You don't... The lease doesn't expire and then you say, oh, but you had promised me that every promise should be in writing. Get competent people, get a good lawyer, let them negotiate for you some good document, and it will protect your investment.
Okay, thank you very much, Jet, and viewers. It's always not enough time for us. However, I hope you learned something. If you missed any of our shows in the past and you want to go back to get the information, go to our YouTube channel NTV and search for the link. That was the link tonight. Thank you for joining us.